Hello, my pastries, and welcome to the Poptart podcast. I'm your host, Dryas, and we're here today with George, the fellow owner of this channel, and Christian, our guest. We'll be talking about our thoughts on Overwatch, the new consoles, and the best E3 games. So let's begin. So, George, let's hit it off with Overwatch. Your thoughts on the game and how it seems to work.
I don't like it.
Just laying it out right there.
I know that I'm like really unpopular in my opinion, right? But simple truth is I don't like it. Like, and I should. Like, I feel like it would be a game that would be like the best for me. It should be my favorite game. I love competitive shooters. CS:GO and Rainbow Six are like some of my favorite games. So I don't know about CS:GO, but Rainbow Six definitely. But something about it just doesn't click with me. And I feel like there was a bunch of problems that I think the game has. Like, I think the game is well made. Like, I'm not bringing the game down like a peg or two. Like, I feel it's a good game, but it's not for me. Like, the fact that it didn't launch with ranked was kind of an issue for me. Like, and then I just don't think I don't think the gameplay sits well with me. It's too much, too fast, right? Mm-hmm. Whereas you look at the competitive shooters I do like, they're a lot more slow and methodical and thought out.
Yeah.
This game is like, go, 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 go. And I was saying to you guys earlier, I think of it as the casual competitive game.
Mm-hmm.
That, I know that doesn't make any sense, but what I mean by that is the fact that it's a game that can be played by casuals in a competitive way, but isn't competitive like CS:GO, right?
Yes.
If I met someone who doesn't really play games, I could give this to them, like someone who plays like Call of Duty or something like that. They could get somewhat competitive at it, and they could get competitive at it and kind of get into the game. Mm-hmm. And I think it fills that niche. It feels too much like TF2.
Yeah.
So like, Christian, what about you?
Well, I mean, I like Overwatch because of the art style. Just, I like how all the characters have their own personalities and just the overall feeling of how the game is. Just, I know that sounds just really weird, but just kind of like having a secret lore behind it. And even though I don't really mind games like TF2 and I'm kind of a competitive person like CS:GO kind of game, just gameplay wise, art style wise, and development wise, just Overwatch is just great. I don't really see an issue with it.
Yeah, with your point on the story, I do agree the fact that today, I don't know why, what the purpose was, but for some reason I was recalling all the Overwatch characters, and I could recall probably 80 to 90% of them, and I've only played an hour of the game. Whereas in Rainbow Six, I still sometimes forget the characters. Not that often, but that game I have like 100 hours in,
yeah,
right?
The characters are more flashy. They're everywhere. But, each character.
But isn't that what's gonna happen in this fantasy setting? You know what I mean? Like, that's what's gonna happen. Whereas in Rainbow Six is a lot more realistic in that sense. Like, they all kind of look the same, mm-hmm. Which there's nothing wrong with that. That's kind of what happens in the military. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just feel this game as a whole seems to feel a little bit too much like Team Fortress 2. And I believe that sometimes it's okay to make games that are like, that feel a lot alike, but it seems to be playing on the fact that
I feel like if this game was made by a different company, no one would care, i.e. mm-hmm. Battleborn.
Yeah.
Like, no one cared about that game, and I knew it wasn't as good as Overwatch, but I feel like that game got unfairly, like, not...
Well, I mean...
It's riding on Blizzard's name.
I feel like this game is somewhat riding on Blizzard's name.
Mm-hmm.
Not entirely, but it's definitely right. It's, like, definitely hanging on that.
Well, I mean, Battleborn is supposed to appeal to, like, people who play League of Legends and Call of Duty at the same time. Like, Borderlands fans also even, because it has the MOBA feel to it, just with how the objectives are laid out.
I feel like Blizzard is just, and this team that was trying to create Titan, they saw that Team Fortress 2, it's been several years since Team Fortress 2 was released, and now they're playing off that. They're saying we can make money off the fact that people want another Team Fortress 2 game, and if Valve released a Team Fortress 3. And it was like this, I would have no quarrels with this game. I just feel that Blizzard is just hitting it a little bit too close to the ballpark, with the same objectives, the same characters.
Yeah, why is it that when this game launched for $60, if you got the Origins Edition, it's kind of lacking gameplay.
It really is.
And no one cared. But with Rainbow Six, and I honestly, I know I'm going to get a lot of hate for this, Rainbow Six launched with probably more content, honestly. Like, I mean, you have more maps. You have three modes instead of two. And you have Terrorist Hunt, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the situations, who cares about the situations, right? I feel like that's a little unfair. I didn't know that Rainbow Six launched in a much worse state than Overwatch did. It's not as polished.
You've got to give it to Blizzard. It is a pretty polished game.
Yeah, it's definitely polished. And I think Blizzard's good at that, right? But content-wise, the game is actually lacking. When you really think about it, like, it doesn't have that much content. I mean, I know CSGO. Why is it that CSGO has more content, even though it's way less money?
Well, I mean,
it's got, like, CSGO 20, is supposed to be 20 to 30 maps, right?
Yeah. A competitive mode, arms race, demolition.
Yeah. So, but, I mean, in general, these games are meant to be played forever with simplistic gameplay that's, like, addictive. That's the point of these games. So I'm not that mad about that, but still, when people hate on other games for not having enough content, like Battlefront, but then Overwatch...
That had more content than Overwatch. Yeah, I mean, it had better graphics, it had a better feel to it. It was a beautiful game, but people didn't like that. And...
Oh, because there was no campaign.
Yeah, I get that, but Overwatch doesn't have a campaign. It's crazy. Just
they
how
had a campaign
that name, before, Blizzard, honestly. The Blizzard and the field that it was TF2. There's people who used to play TF2, like there's no tomorrow. They came back and they said, this is my game. My friend Nick, who I wanted to get into this call, but he wasn't able to be here today. I hope I can get him into some other podcast. But my friend Nick, he plays Team Fortress 2 competitively. He's got a several $1,000s inventory in Team Fortress 2. He loves playing that game. And when Overwatch came out, what game did he play for day and night? He played it like there was no tomorrow because it is Team Fortress 2. They're taking these people
it's a better version of TF2. Like, you can't argue that. Like,
yes, I can't argue.
It's definitely better than that.
It's just, like, more... Like, even though TF2's characters had definite personality to them, and that's kind of like I...
TF2 was released in 2010. It's been 6 years, and after 6 years, you need another game. And that is Valve's fault for not creating Team Fortress 3. If they created Team Fortress 3...
Well, no, CSGO was released in 2012. But I do agree that CSGO wasn't really released until 2013 because they didn't have the comp mode and skins and all that stuff.
2014 is when it exploded. Was when it
Yeah,
fully
but when did the arms race come out? Arms race update. Was that 2014 or 2013?
I think it was 14 because that's when there's the first major.
Just because, yeah, but that doesn't necessarily mean that's when it, like, the starts, though, so. I don't know.
Anyways, but it just, and then you also have to say, I want to talk about the microtransactions now. Oh, my God.
Well, I mean, wait, before we move on to microtransactions, this is about George's point of not being enough content. Now, I know this game has nothing to do with what we're talking about, just bear with me here. Splatoon had zero content to it, it had content to it, but I mean, it didn't have much content to it. And then they started adding rank, they started adding new maps slowly, one by one. And then,
yes, that is true. He's got a point. Splatoon didn't launch with that much, but it has been getting free content, and so will Overwatch. Will be getting free content, but I still think Splatoon had more, though. I thought,
well, I mean, Splatoon, it only had like, I can't remember, like eight maps, no, not eight, not even eight maps. I think it only had like five maps. I think they didn't have many items or like customizable abilities. They just had campaign, the regular...
Yeah, there's a campaign.
Which is already...
Why is it that everyone complains about campaign even though no one plays it?
I play campaign.
No, I know, but the people, like, it's always like, oh, Rainbow Six didn't have a campaign. I'm like, yeah, most of you
would... Rainbow Six isn't supposed to be a campaign. I mean, they could have...
You know, yeah, it is, Christian. Like,
I mean, CSGO has a campaign. With their operations, Counter-Strike has a story. No, they do. They have a story behind it.
I don't know if I count... Campaign is different. Like,
I mean, it has a story behind it.
They use the word campaign more in the sense of a political campaign. Like, I know that's a weird idea, but, like, it's more of an idea of a set of... like missions that you do, whereas in a campaign, and like, because the older Rainbow Six were super story based, like they were like, you know what I mean? So
Battlefield didn't start having a story until after like Battlefield 1999 or whatever.
1999? That never existed.
Not 1999. It's like 1990 something. 1945? Yeah, Battlefield 1945 or something weird like that. They didn't add.
That's
like,
when World War II ended. So it would have been 19. It was 19.
Oh my God! You get my point. Battlefield 1942. Okay. Thank you. Insert what he just said here, and they didn't have a campaign until a couple installments after.
Mm-hmm. But that was back in like the 90s.
Yeah, but I mean,
they get an excuse.
And well, so now I want to move on to microtransactions, because this is my biggest problem, is the microtransactions. The fact that they didn't create a market is what kind of gets me, is that they had this chance.
Yeah, they should have made a market.
They've made perfect markets. World of Warcraft.
Something is, if I'm not going to win 300 games and get a golden gun and not trade it with somebody, it's like,
I don't think the golden gun should have had a market, though.
Golden guns shouldn't have a market.
Them, like, those should have been only for people who earned them, right?
Yeah. Because
you could easily just be a new account and then get a ton of those and like, oh, look how much I've played the game. But you know what I mean?
Should have had a market. You should have been able to make money off the skins, but at the same time, you also have to say that, well, you get the cases and you're just buying skins, and I can understand that. But there's just no value to it. I don't want to spend money to buy these things, and it's just, they could have made a lot of money off that. They could have.
Yeah, they could have made more money if they actually had a value.
Yeah.
Like, I know they're already making money off those cases, but they could have made even more.
Yeah, it's just, it's kind of, the cosmetics don't do anything. There's just kind of, the game stays static. It's a static game.
The problem is that all your arguments for this are same with CSGO. My biggest problem is the gameplay. Like, it's just not for me. Like, I don't like that floaty style. That's my biggest problem with it. Everything else is like, it's not really a huge gripe. It's just kind of an issue with, but I don't really care. I just don't like the game because of the gameplay. If that wasn't a problem, then I would have probably loved the game. I feel like it should be, I should like it, but I don't. The microtransactions I don't have a huge issue with, especially since so many other games have them. Yeah.
The only problem I have at Overwatch in terms of microtransactions is just how none of the items really have value, and the whole golden gun thing is just kind of stupid, because I get it that Overwatch games are shorter than CSGO, but
You're the only one who's hung up on this golden gun.
Yeah, that's just you.
I'm just saying, I don't know why it bugs me, it just kind of does. It's like, well, win 300 games, good golden tracer guns, like what now? It's kind of...
Same with CSGO. CSGO is even worse, because you don't get, like, rewards for playing for so long.
Yeah, but I mean, like,
Uh-huh.
Well, yeah, touche, but I mean, you get drops in Acris Vell, drop over here, Darius.
Woo!
Yeah, but you know how few people get that?
Yeah.
Like, he's probably the only one who got that drop that day. Maybe a couple other people, but you get what I'm saying, right?
Oh, yeah.
So...
But
I mean, that it has value to it, at least. Just saying.
So I'm actually really excited to move on to the next topic. But let's just recap. So, George, you're against this game. You're just you don't.
I don't hate the game. I think it's a good game. It's not for me. I just don't like the gameplay, and the fact that it didn't launch with ranked kind of sucks too.
Okay, how about you, Christian?
I like it. Just kind of good art style, good gameplay. I don't see any problems with it. Just kind of. Okay. On all fields.
Yeah, I mean, I just feel it seems a little bit like Team Fortress 2, and I don't think that it would. It's definitely writing off Blizzard's name, and I don't think it deserves all of the hurrah and the excitement it's getting. But other than that, you know, it's a decent game. I mean,
I know I shouldn't be bringing this up, but I think the reason why people liked it all of a sudden is for a couple of reasons. I think because TF2 was out for 6 years, they were getting bored of it, right? And they kind of left TF2, and it wasn't serious enough, and it was too chaotic, right? Mm-hmm. This is like a happy medium between CSGO and TF2, and it's what everyone wants. It's not what I want, but it's what everyone else wants. So, or at least the 7 million people who own it. So...
Well said.
Yeah,
Okay, so we're going to move on to the next topic now, which is Project Scorpio versus Project Neo. The PS4
Neo. Project Neo.
Sorry, it's PS4
Neo. PS4 Neo, and we'll also mention NX.
Sorry.
We're also mentioning NX.
Okay.
Okay, a couple things. First of all, I'm surprised PS4 Neo and NX, were neither one of them were at E3. And I know both of them were announced before.
Before,
they weren't gonna be there, but I'm still surprised they weren't. Like, I mean, I get NX because they wanted to focus on Zelda, but NX is coming out next year. And NX I could give a slide to, right? But PS4 Neo is supposed to launch in, I think, October. Or somewhere this fall, I thought. But I may be wrong. I don't know. I don't like the idea of upgradable consoles. I think it's dumb.
Yeah, and
you already the real reason Neo came out was for PS4 VR.
Yeah.
That's the only reason it came out, is because I knew the PS4 VR would not work on the base console. So you'd have to buy a Neo. And when you think about it then, it's as expensive as an HTC Vive. You have to pay $400 for the console and another $400 for the headset. It's $800 right there.
Microsoft is actually doing
something. $800 for a headset?
What?
Microsoft
pays $400 for a headset.
It's just weird. VR headset.
It's just got touch things. It's cool. No, it's actually pretty complicated technology.
Yeah.
It's not, like, I think it costs probably around $400 to make, but the amount of money they had in development is probably what you're paying for.
Now, what I have to bring up right now is Microsoft's genius in announcing Scorpio and the Xbox One S, because the PS4
I don't get the point of Xbox S.
I think it's just supposed to be kind of like a stealthy, more like a stronger version of the Xbox One.
I thought it was just an alternative to the Xbox One, like what they did for the original Xbox 360. They had a slim version.
Maybe I think it's just slimmer, more powerful version. Maybe
I don't think it's more powerful. I think that's what Scorpio's job is. It's just slimmer with a better hard drive and probably like. That's probably it. Like small improvements that don't affect gameplay, but affect like usability, like load times, probably, or stuff like that. You know what I mean?
Now, what you have to give to Microsoft, and what I was saying before, was that they announced both of them, but PS4 is keeping tight-lipped about this, and the NX. They're both that stupid. It's because Microsoft is now saying, we've got two consoles, here's what they look like, get hyped, it's going to be amazing, versus PS4, where people, I didn't even realize they're releasing Neo until today, and I have never heard of the NX until just a few minutes ago. So, Microsoft has been...
Okay, Nintendo's reasoning for keeping secret with the NX is because they claim it's like the next big thing for gaming. Like,
and it's a flop like the Wii U was.
The Wii U? Oh, I thought you said the Wii. I'm like, the Wii U was the second best-selling console of all time.
I think the only thing keeping the Wii U afloat right now is Splatoon and maybe Xenoblade. I don't know.
Christian, those are the two games that are not... No one plays Splatoon. Xenoblade is not keeping it afloat. Maybe Splatoon. It's mainly Smash, Zelda, and like those games. Not Xenoblade. The main people don't care about Xenoblade. But Nintendo is claiming that because the NX is 2 years out, it's not releasing until like, or not 2 years, a year out, late 2017, I think. They don't want to reveal it yet because they're worried people are going to steal the ideas. So okay. I guess they're super confident about the product. So I don't like care about.
Yeah, Nintendo's like really touchy about their content. And
and then PS4 Neo, I don't know what's up with that. They're just kind of whacked out right now. And then
The PS4 Neo, all it's doing is it's just going to say we're going to have better power, right now. It's saying it's going to be bigger, better, stronger.
That's what Scorpio's thought. Right?
But Scorpio's also there's some other things about it that are pretty good.
Oh yeah. Okay, two more.
It's gonna be stronger than a. It's pretty much gonna be a computer. Imagine a computer just with the control. Yeah. That's what they're saying. It's gonna be, just like that.
Yeah, So two topics on that. First of all, Xbox Design Lab. I'm so pumped about that. The fact you can make your custom colored Xbox One controllers is awesome.
That was pretty cool.
Like I want that. Like I actually may get one for my PC because there's a couple games I could use that for. Secondly, recently in the past couple months. I was just in my mind, I'm like, if I'm ever going to get an Xbox One or PS4, which one would I get? Because right now, even though PS4 has the better exclusives, Microsoft as a company is knocking it out of the ballpark, okay? The fact that they want to do cross-platform play between
with PS4, PC, that's going to have to make... No, it's PS4, PC, and Xbox.
Right now, Xbox. People can play Rocket League on PC and Xbox One together.
Yeah,
right now.
That is... Like, they're amazing. They are doing well with this. Microsoft, they are pushing that. I've been waiting for this moment, and I am so glad it's Microsoft.
Microsoft is breaking down the walls in the fact that why don't we just be one big... Not family, but the leader of Xbox is like, console fanboys are dumb. Like, yeah. Just pick the console you want to play on. We should all be together. Like, you know, like he wants to, you know, like Quantum Break came out on PC and yeah, it was broken. Yeah. But, you know, they're announcing a lot of games that are beyond Xbox for PC. I'm applauding Microsoft for the fact they're opening the floodgates and they're like, let's actually...
And they totally can. Microsoft has Windows. Windows is what you run Steam on. They can totally do this.
That's the thing, though. PS4 isn't. It's not as easy for Sony to do it as Xboxes. Yeah. But I'm applauding Micro. I'm so glad that Microsoft is doing all this stuff because it's like breaking down the It's like let's just hang out together. Let's not be such toxic about which one's better. You know what I mean? I like the idea of PC Master Race, and I do think PCs are the best, but I'm not...
I mean, PC, you can get any game, and...
It's going to have six teraflops.
But, I mean, this is the only thing I really have an issue with, PC, is that if you don't have a good enough computer, then you're basically kind of messed up, but...
Well, now what they're saying is, just spend $400, buy an Xbox Scorpio,
yeah.
And you have the same exact performance.
Yeah, I'm I was watching a video, and this guy was saying we should be on the 9th generation of consoles, not the 8th. And the reason he said that is because the consoles of last generation released in 2006 and went to 2014. Okay?
More innovative.
That's 8 years. Most of the consoles before that were only 4 or 5 years. And what happened is he said that when the 2008 market crash happened, no one made any consoles. So we skipped a generation. So the consoles should be more powerful right now, but they're not because the market crash. Mm-hmm. So the consoles are way behind PCs right now. I remember I was playing The Division at my cousin's house on his PS4, and I kind of died on the inside.
Wait, why? Was it bad?
No, it was just 30 FPS, and they're like...
Wait, on a PS4, really?
Yeah.
PS4 suck.
Excuse me.
I know PS4 isn't really the best thing in the world, but 30 frames. How much does your computer run Division again?
60 FPS. Mine's at ultra. Generally speaking, PS4s and Xbox One play the games at medium settings, and they get 30 FPS. That's a good it's generally between medium and high at 30 FPS.
Because at 30 FPS,
compared to their PC,
which And it was fantastic. You heard about IGN, who, with Overwatch, since we were just talking about Overwatch, they did a video comparison video. They had Overwatch PC settings on low to compare
to
the... It was GameSpot who did that. And they had it on low to compare it to the PS4 version so that they could say it looks the same. But it was on low on the PC. I mean, there's just... You can't do that. You don't do that.
Yeah. I'm so glad I switched to PC, and I know we're starting to switch topics to PC elitism now.
Fucking PC elitist bullshit.
Hey, Nick.
Hey.
Okay, guys, so...
No, get him out of the cult. Goodbye.
No.
Not again.
Okay, so moving on.
Wait, I didn't get him out, by the way.
I think he left. I think he left.
Okay. Anyway, I don't know. I'm not, mad about these. Earlier I did say I was mad, but I take that back. I feel bad for console owners. We have to do another upgrade. I just bought the $400 version. I don't want to buy another one. You know what I mean? I feel bad for the console people. Whereas in PC, it gives that flexibility. You upgrade...
PC, you don't have to really upgrade anything.
You can upgrade when you want to. Really, that's the whole point of PC
gaming. The only hinder, I guess, on the, upgradability. This is PC's version of upgrading, would be the operating system, because some games I think are going to be Windows 10 exclusive next year, which is going to really weird. But
no, that's for Windows Store. Steam games are going to be on whatever one, I think. But the ones that Microsoft is selling.
Yeah, I was talking about Steam in general.
But no, Steam is going to still support Windows 8 and 7 for a while.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure up until one or two years ago they stopped supporting Vista. So and no one liked Vista. So yeah.
The reason why
Microsoft is only releasing Windows 10 is because they want everyone to upgrade to Windows 10. So
that's your free Windows upgrade of Windows 10. No, you can get. Oh, you didn't do your free Windows 10 upgrade.
Wait, Christian, you didn't do it.
I don't have a Windows.
Oh yeah, you've got your Mac. So yeah, I think we can all agree Xbox and Microsoft right now are going to be, they're winning this race right now.
Wait, who is?
Xbox and Microsoft in general.
I don't know why, but I thought you said Xbox
and Minecraft. And not Minecraft. Why are you saying Xbox and Microsoft? What you're doing categories?
Okay. Company-wise, Microsoft is better. They're just a better company. But PS4, right, they're selling more, and I think their exclusives are better, right?
Yeah.
But, if I had to pick a console, I would buy probably the Xbox because of how good the company is, and I want to support them. So, I don't want this to backfire them and then to stop doing it, and then no one ever does it again because it didn't work for them, so it won't work for them. You know what I mean? Okay. So I want this to work because
it's just gonna be the next big thing.
One big family.
So okay, so we're gonna take a little break in the video right now. We're gonna add Nick to the call and we're gonna see his next E3 game. See you guys in a second. Hey guys, so we're back and turns out Nick didn't want to join us. We got denied. So, we're going to start out with our top E3 games. We're going to do three E3 games and then one indie game. We're going to go just right out of the blue. Let's just name them all off. And we talked, and I'm going to begin. So, my first game, oh man, I think this is obvious, Battlefield 1. Oh, that game looks amazing. It's got that World War 1 feel to it's based in World War 1. Everybody's been wanting this. The creators of Battlefield... oh god, EA just they saw what people
normally
were asking for.
Suck,
yeah, no. This time they're just like, we got you, bro. And so I'm excited. And the next one, of course,
wait, before we go off of Battlefield 1, I do have to say, this hype train is getting a little bit too strong. Okay, remember what happened with the launch of Battlefield 4? That thing was buggy for a year. I got the game a couple months ago, and that's 2 years after launch, and it works fine now. But the game was buggy. I'm just saying, look out for the disappointments. I still think the game looks amazing, and I'm definitely hyped for it. But be on the lookout.
Next thing, Civ 6. I've played 200 hours of Civilization.
Let me verify that right now.
Okay, I think I've played 200 hours. Let me check before I start.
No, here, I'll check.
It's good.
Okay, talk while you're
checking. Okay, 138 hours. Close enough, okay? Don't judge me. 138 hours of Civilization 5, and I love that game. My dad my parents love playing that game. My dad was the first one to ever show me Civilization. We used to play Civilization 4 and 3 on our old computer because that game was amazing, and we just love Civilization as a whole. And so I know without a doubt I'm gonna pre-order this game. I want Civilization 6. I've been waiting for such a long time. With the ability of being able to stack troops, that's just gonna be so amazing. I hate that you have to put your warriors first and then your settlers, or your settlers and then your warriors, and just it leaves them vulnerable.
I actually have not been paying attention to that game. I'm hyped for it, right?
But you're okay.
I haven't really been paying attention to the media on that game.
Okay.
I didn't know about that stackable thing or whatever.
Oh yeah. And then there's Outer Scrolls 5 Special Edition. Oh my gosh.
Mod it. I don't get why everyone's so excited for that game when you can just mod the game.
Shush. I actually have 200 hours in this game, 290
to be
exact.
Yeah, I was about to say you've got 210 on whatever your account.
Yeah, hours on that game. I love Skyrim. Don't you judge me. It's the best game of all time.
Skyrim's good.
It was my first game that I ever got on my new computer, and it is my love. It's my game.
I don't like it.
Shut up. Shut up, George, okay?
That's for another video, but I don't like that game.
Yeah, we're going to have another podcast.
Wait, we're talking about Skyrim, right?
Yes, I don't like Skyrim.
We're going to have a whole other podcast on this.
I have a problem with Skyrim. I like Mass Effect better, just saying.
Why would you compare Skyrim and Mass Effect?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think it's just open world-wise, but whatever.
I'm shaking my head right now.
I don't know if I would say Mass Effect is open world.
No, I was, for some reason, I was thinking of Mass Effect when you said Skyrim. For some reason, I don't know why. Just kind
of. Anyway, I don't like Skyrim. End of discussion. We'll talk about that in another video. But I don't like that
game. Excuse me, guys, while I go up to George's house and shoot him. So, yeah, that's a whole other discussion. I love the feeling of Skyrim. I love that moment when you're sitting down there and you see a herd of deer running and you pull back your bow and my stealth skills maxed out so time seems to slow and you aim and you see your arrow arc through the air and it lands in the deer and the deer goes, ah! And then, or when you're with mammoths and I'm riding on my horse and I'm riding up to a mammoth and I'm cutting down the mammoth, and or I'm fighting giants, or I'm killing dragons. Fusoda! Yeah, I love Skyrim.
That was kind of cringe.
Yeah, that was.
Hey, don't judge me. I love Skyrim. Now, top indie game, Absolver.
Yeah, that game looked good.
Yeah, martial arts, and the fact that wasn't even on the show floor, it was actually in a parking lot, a block away from the convention center. That's pretty funny. And it looks cool. I liked Blade and Soul, which was sort of like that.
Kind of, kind of not. I don't know. I get where you're coming from, but...
Yeah, I think it's going to be a bit like that game. And I like those kinds of games, but I hope it's first person. What would be cool...
It's not first person.
Oh, it's not first person. Oh, man, dude. I would love to have a martial arts game for VR. Like a mad, just like dish, 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 dish.
Well, it's probably already
been. Why would that?
That'd be pretty cool. Or like, I like to have Skyrim VR and just, or like a sword game in general where you can swing a sword. That's what I.
They announced Fallout 4 for VR.
Oh, yeah.
Guys, they should make a Sword Art Online game VR.
No one likes Sword Art Online.
I'm joking. That was the point of man.
Okay.
We all know Sword Online sucks.
Okay, so Christian, you go now.
You go.
Alright, E3 games, Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Okay, I get that.
I'm gonna be on that like ham and butter, because I'm
happy too.
I'm a Pokemon person, so always have been. ReCore.
That looks good. That's from the same people that made,
Metroid Prime. I love Metroid Prime.
No, not just them, it's being published by the same company that made Mighty No. 9.
Actually, guys.
Yeah, I don't care. I care about Metroid Prime because Metroid Prime was my life.
But Mighty No. 9 sucked.
Well, yeah, that's why I still Metroid Prime. So I'm gonna be on that.
I don't know. Just ReCore just feels kind of generic.
It feels puzzly, as from what I just saw. So me being a fan of Portal puzzly games, probably gonna play that.
I mean, it looks okay.
And I know this has nothing to do with the gameplay, but the trailer music was. Just saying. I had the song on my plate.
Santiago.
Oh my gosh, I'm mentioning cheese.
According to Christian, that's not a real food.
Oh my, I didn't. No, I said that's not a real thing. I thought it was just a random Spanish word you were making up.
How would it? Whatever.
No, you said hola right after that. So
I said, wait, what is I think actually ReCore is considered indie.
Is ReCore not? It's not considered indie, really? Isn't it being published by Bungie, kind of, in half, also?
Bungie?
No, I said, I don't know, I read somewhere that Bungie's...
Yeah, ReCore is not a AAA game, it's a low-budget indie game.
Alright, then put that as my indie pick, I don't care.
Yeah, you know KJ Inafune, the guy who made Mighty No. 9? He's also making ReCore.
Oh.
So whatever. The people who made Metroid Prime, Retro Studios?
Yeah.
I don't think they're making...
Retro Studios isn't, indie.
Yeah, but they're not making this game.
I mean, it's from one of the creators of... They're not making it, but I mean, one of the people that made Metroid Prime are switching over to ReCore.
Oh.
I don't know, look it up. So, don't know if I should put the indie list or not. I'm just going to say what the indie game is. Insider. Because same person that made Limbo, and I
No, Inside. It's not Insider. It's Insider.
Inside, whatever. Same people that made Limbo. I liked Limbo, so I'm going to be probably buying that when I get a better computer, because my computer's a toaster. And then with Darius, Battlefield 1.
Yeah. Okay, so I looked it up, and it's not a guy from Retro Studios. It's a guy from Destiny. The guy who left Destiny before the game was made when the story was rewritten. Back when the story for Destiny was good. Mm. You know, before it got released. So. That's what it sounds like, at least.
Oh.
So. So my E3 games of 2015 are, so first, I'm going to start off with Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I don't know why none of you have mentioned this. Whew, this game looks, it just looks like perfect. It just, like, technically it's not that amazing, right? It's not, I mean, I like the art style, but it's pretty ugly. It looks like a PS3, Xbox 360 game, but it just looks amazing. Like, the gameplay looks awesome.
Which game? What?
Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But I don't know. I'm just so pumped for it. I like almost all the Legend of Zelda games, except for like Spirit Tracks and Phantom Hourglass.
Spirit Tracks are just ugly.
Well, it's a DS game. That's not my problem. The problem.
No, I mean it wasn't ugly. Just it was bad.
I don't like the stylus. That this is dumb. But yeah, this game looks amazing. My second game is Ghost Recon Wildlands. I know it's an Ubisoft game, and I should not be hyped for this, but it looks like my kind of game. I like stealth games. It's my favorite genre of the idea that you have an objective, but your way of doing that objective is up to you.
Like Metal Gear Solid.
Metal Gear Solid 5, yeah. And so this looks like a similar thing. This basically looks like, to me, Metal Gear Solid 5, but with 4 people. And that sounds amazing to me. Mm-hmm. So... That's what I wish Metal Gear Online was 4-man co-op on missions. That's what I wish it was, but it was dumb PvP or whatever. But yeah, and then my third game is Prey, which got re-released because Prey 2 got canceled, and this is being it's really convoluted. And generally speaking, I don't like Bethesda games, but this game looks amazing.
Oh, no wonder you hate Skyrim.
I don't like Skyrim because, like, I just don't like Bethesda games. That's not – I don't hate Skyrim.
So you're saying that you don't like Fallout?
Yes, but Fallout and Skyrim are the same. You can't even, like – it's just the same thing in different settings with slightly different mechanics. You can't even argue with me on that one.
You know, when I was making the whole comparing Mass Effect to Skyrim thing, I was probably thinking of Fallout with a Mass Effect.
Yeah. Okay, anyway, so Prey looks like the greatest thing ever. It's a psychological shooter. Or psychological horror shooter, which is psychological horror is one of my favorite genres of any media, really. Games and movies and books and anything really is amazing, and it's a shooter, and it just the trailer was super trippy.
Find trippy in that sentence.
Well, did you see trippy the trailer? Did you see the trailer?
No.
Oh, okay. Never mind. It's hard to explain. You have to go watch it.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I'm just gonna look it up right now. You guys can die.
And then my indie game is Abzu. Which is like it's made by the same people who made Journey for the PS3. It's just a beautiful game. It just looks like a fun, relaxing game that I could play at any moment. My second pick for indie would be probably Absolvers, but Abzu just looks good. Like I want to play it. It just looks like a relaxing game, and I like the ocean. It just looks fun. So those are my three games.
Right,
my three games.
Prey.
And a half.
Prey.
Prey. Trailer. Let's not have a live reaction of Christian playing this game, though.
Yeah.
I mean,
so, no, there you have it, guys. Thanks for tuning into our podcast. If you guys did enjoy, please hit that like button down below. Of course, we were leaving Christian's channels. Link in the description below. I was your host, Darius, with the other host, George. And we hope to see you guys next week. Peace.